When Dog fell in the Sierra Madre Casino, two died as one. Dog died hungry, alone, frightened. The voice in his head died with him, screaming, furious, enraged. But the voice was gone, and Dog was grateful. At least Dog was dead, and the voice needed to watch over him no more. In the moment before their lives ended, the wall between the two personalities fell. The two became silent as they saw the chain between them. Hunger and control are twin greeds, something Dog and his shadow had never realized. Dog forgot himself, as did the voice that raged within him. After their passing, a new voice spoke within the mutant shell. It was difficult for the voice to remember the two it once was. There was the beast, Dog, consumed by hunger. And the other, in reverse, the one consumed by control. Both were driven by need for the other. The courier brought them together somehow, joined the two into one. All that happened at the Sierra Madre was a faint memory to the new personality, like a flickering light in the clouds of the mind. The new voice did not think of the courier again until the battle at the Divide reached his ears. The battle between the two couriers, beneath the torn skies and the old world flag, each bearing a message for the other. And the mutant prayed the courier that had saved him had been saved in return.
Dog, free of the voice inside his head and no longer waiting on the voice of the master, wandered back west. His hunger never ended. Often, small communities would suddenly vanish. They were assumed to have been hit by wasteland creatures and dragged away. Dogs, Brahmin, and humans alike.
Freed of both Dog and the one who held Dog's leash, the other voice resumed control. First the mind, then finally, the mutant shell. His first act was to tend to the scars on the body with careful hands, slowly healing all the scars, except the ragged name torn on his chest. He briefly thought of remaining at the Sierra Madre, but it was a monument built by humans, representing something he no longer needed. He began walking west, in search of others like him. As he did, he spoke of the courier who had set him free and allowed his life to begin again.